Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we have a fun lesson for you. So we're going to go over the if statement, and then after that we're going to go over some special sum statements, and then finally we're going to cover the count statement. So I would like to teach you how to use the sum if, the sum ifs, the if, and the ifs statements. I'm going to use my recipe planning spreadsheet right here. When I'm looking at my recipe planning spreadsheet, over here starting at column H, I have what I am planning for the week in H-I-N-J. I'm going to make some mashed potatoes and some sweet potatoes and some pan-fried salmon. Over here on the left, I have a list of my ingredients, and in this inventory column, I have how much I have on hand right now before I go to the grocery store. So I'm going to go to my recipe needs right here, and I'm going to do a sum if. And let me explain what that is going to do. When I put a sum if in here, I only want to put a sum total if what's in column A matches what's over here in column I. So first I'm being asked for a range. And the range that I want to put is anything from I to J and all the way down, because these are the items that I need for my recipe. My next argument is my criteria. I don't want the total sum of all of these ingredients here. I only want them if this cell in I matches what's over here. So I'm going to click on cell A2. And then the final argument I will be asked for is this sum range. So I'm going to highlight this range of data right here. And that's going to give me my sum total of only the ingredients in the first column that match what's over here in butter. So I'm going to hit enter, and my recipe needs now say 1.5. Is that true? If I look over here, I need one butter here, and I need a stick of butter here. So yes, that is true. Next, I'm going to copy my formula down. But I'm going to look here, and it's a very strange thing that has happened. It says that I need 0 potatoes when I can look over here and see that I clearly need 6. And I'm really glad that this came up, because this is a tip in Excel that is very important. So if I click here and I look at my data range, look at that. When I copied my formula, my data range right here no longer goes from I3 to J17, but it moved with my formula. Now I wanted potatoes to move down 1, but I do not want this range of data that I'm looking at to be moving at all. I want it to always remain I3 to J17. I'm going to use the dollar sign. And what I'm going to do there is put a dollar sign right here at the J, and then I'm going to put another dollar sign, and I'm going to change this to a 3. And then in front of this one, I'm going to also put dollar signs in front of that and change it to 17. But now if you're noticing, my data is off a little bit, so I have to do the same thing for I. So I'm going to put a dollar sign before the column name and a dollar sign before the row, and I'm going to change that row back to a 3. And I'm going to put a dollar before the column and a dollar before the row, and I'm going to change that one back to 17. So now if I look over to the right, I have the correct data range in there. The reason I do need 6 potatoes as well. So now when I copy that formula all the way down, I'm going to see that I can look over here and I need 3 salts. 1, 2, 3. I need no breadcrumbs because it's not found in the list, etc. So that this is working correctly. That is the sum if function. Next, we're going to go to the regular if function. So now, over here, I want to put an X in this column if I actually need to go to the grocery store and buy that item. So right now, I'm going to do if and put a parenthesis. So if what's in what I need minus what I already have is greater than 0, then I hit the comma. What is my value going to be if this is true? I would like to put an X in this column right here. So an X should appear in here. But what if I'm putting a comma, what if the value is false? What do I want to appear in this column? I'm going to put two sets of double quotes so nothing appears in this column. And then I'm going to hit enter. Next, I'm going to copy the formula all the way to the bottom. Now I can see that everything I need is checked off. Next, what I would like to do is sum this column only if there is an X. And not only that, but I would also like to break it out by store so I have a grocery list for each store that I'm going to. So if I click in my cell and type sum if S left parenthesis, the first question is, what is my sum range? I'm going to pick all of the prices and then I'm going to put a comma. Now I'm asked my criteria range. I'm going to say here, and then I'm going to say that criteria is that it has an X. I now have an optional argument after I put a comma in for criteria range 2. And what I would like to do there is sum up this column with a comma, but only if it says in double quotes, Kroger. Once I hit enter, I can see that my total will be $2.99 at Kroger. Let's go back and see if it's true. There's an X here, but those are at Costco. There's an X here, but those are at Sam and Costco. And there's only one in Kroger, and it's $2.99. So I'm just going to write Kroger total here. Let's do another one. Let's do a similar sum if S. My sum range is this price here. And then my criteria range is this here, again, because I want it to be if it's a capital X. And then my range 2 is going to be this column over here if it is Costco. And then I'm going to hit enter. And that total right there says 1616. And I'm going to say Costco total here so I can keep them separate in my mind. Now let's see if that's correct. This is about $3, $5, $10, so that's $15, $16. Yep, it's about right. So that is calculating correctly. The final function I would like to show you here is the IFS statement. So right here, I'm going to click in here. See how I have a normal if? But I'm only buying something if my recipe needs exceed my inventory. I would also like to add in that if I have zero in inventory, I would also like to buy that at the store. So right up here, I'm going to write IFS, and I'm going to be given a logical test. So I'm going to use the same logical test. This minus this is greater than zero, then I want an X in here. But now here's another statement. I can do a second logical test here. I would also like to say if this column equals zero, because that means I need to buy that at the store too, then I want to put an X in this column as well. So now I have two logical tests going on here. And then I can copy that formula all the way down and see what happens. I get a couple of not applicable. That is because the IFS statement does not have a value for when it's false, unlike the standard if statement. But if I look here, let's see if it's correct. Right here, there should be an X because I need one more for my recipe. Right here, there should be an X for the same reason. Right here, there should be one for both. And right here, I have two in inventory and I don't need any, so that's one that I'm not going to buy. But right here, I have zero in inventory and I need some. But let's look down here. My haddock is at zero and my recipe needs is at zero, so I do still need one. And if I look at milk, it's the same thing. The final formulas I would like to go over are count and count if. Count is a function that likes to count how many cells have a number in it. So if you look at my example right here, we have some inventory. We have some part numbers being manufactured on a line, and there's a certain number produced. But it's someone's first day on the job, and they're doing a bunch of data entry errors. If I look down here, there's some letters in there. There's some letters in here, so they really should have numbers in there. So, and you can see that there are 36 rows of data here. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to equal count. I'm being asked for value 1, but I'm going to select this entire column to see how many of these are actually numbers. And once I hit enter, I will see that 31 of these rows have an actual number in it. And that will tell me that I probably need to go back, and I have 36 rows, so I probably need to fix 5 of them. So count is good for evaluating how many cells have a number in it. Another way you can use the count function is to count how many cells have a certain criteria. Like if I'm looking right here, I would like to know how many part numbers I have on line B. So the way I would do that is I would do equals count if how many in column B, and I'm highlighting everything from column B, is, and I'm just going to put a double quote with a capital B. See that there's 7, and if I count here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, there are 7 B. What if I randomize this? I'm going to do that. I'm just going to highlight all of it, go to data, go to sort, and I'm going to sort by the number produced, because that will mix up my data really well. If I go back, my count for how many of these are a B is still 7. I could also copy that formula with Control C on the keyboard, hit enter, and hit Control V, and I could see how many do I have that's an A. So I get 5 of those. And I'm pretty sure if I go back and sort this, I do have 5 A's. So if I just go back to data, sort by part number, I'm going to look back 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I have 5 that are A's. So hopefully that count function is something that you'll be able to use.
If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel and Office skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.